there's medicines for the baby.
Thank you very much. Next question, please.
他にご質問はございますでしょうか。
Also from members of the Japanese press, if you want to like questions, please step forward.
日本の記者からも結構でございます。もしご質問がございましたら。
どうぞ。
フリーランスの石川でございます。ウランバートルからの報道ですと、孫娘のウンニョンさんの旦那さん、夫ですね、旦那さんも同席されたやに、そのように読んだんですが、そうでしたら、その話してる最中に、その旦那さんはなんか口挟むようなことはあったのか、どんな表情だったのか。ちょっと印象をですね、お伺いしたいなと。もし会ってないなら、どっかで会われたのかどうかですね、教えていただければと思います。よろしく。
ウンギョンさん、ウンギョンという名前をですね、聞こえない。
I'm a freelancer. My name is Ishikawa. When you went to Ulaanbaatar, I'd read somewhere that when you were meeting with your granddaughter, that her husband was also in the same room. If that is the case, when you were speaking with your granddaughter and great-granddaughter, could you tell us if he said anything or if you were able to have any impression about him? And if he was not in the room, did you have another opportunity to meet with him? Any information in that regard would be greatly appreciated.すいません。
ウンギョンさんがまず言ったことは、そのなんで日本ではヘギョンちゃんって読むんですかっていうことを言ってました。私は最初からウンギョンっていう名前なのにって言って、これからはウンギョンって言ってくださいっていうことをまず訂正しておりました。それで主人という人と、それからひ孫にあたるその太った女の子と3人がいつも一緒で、お部屋も一緒で、それでいつもその主人という方は細い方でですね、非常に真面目な、なんていうか、本当に真面目な感じの、優しい感じ の、 男性で、小柄な方ですけど、とても仲が良くて、赤ちゃんも大事にして、ぐずったりするとすぐにこう抱っこして、お風呂なんかも自分で小さい時は入れたんですよっていうような話とか、まあ、そういう日常的な生活の話、恵みの小さい時の話とか、よく似たとこありますねっていうような、もう本当に普通のどこのうちでも話すようなおじいさんと孫と、そしてそのお婿さんの話っていうか、本当に政治色っていうの全くなくて、そういう話を通訳の人を入れながら本当に和やかに話させていただきました。とても真面目な感じの、まあ、スキッとした形の男性だと思いました。
And in regard to our first meeting with our granddaughter, the first thing that she said was, you know, I'd like to first of all clarify my name. I know that I've heard that in Japan my name has been given as Hegyon, but it's always been actually Ugyon, and that is my name. So from now on, please always call me by this real name, Ungyon. In regard to your question, it was always the trio together, the trio meaning my granddaughter and her husband and their baby. They would stay in the same room and they were always together, and it was very, very heartwarming to see the very young family together. The husband was a very slender man. He seemed very serious, very gentle and very kind. Not a very tall man, rather a small stature, but the wife and husband seemed to be get along very, very well, and he was, as I said, very, very gentle and kind. Whenever the baby would begin to fuss, he would immediately take the baby and try to hush it and calm it. And through the interpreter, he would explain that he had given baths to the baby even when the baby was very, very small. In other words, what we talked about were really basically everyday things. We would talk about the fact that our great-granddaughter had certain qualities or certain characteristics, and we would compare that with what Megumi had been as a child long ago. In other words, our conversations had absolutely no political context or political intimations or insinuations. It was simply a family getting together and discussing just everyday things. But again, the impression that I had of our grandson-in-law, I suppose, is that he was a very nice man, very straightforward, and the word that is being used is kitoshiteru, which is very direct and not hiding anything, and just very serious and kind.
In general, did you get the impression that your granddaughter is living a good life in North Korea?
私の方からの質問でございます。その、ウンギョンさんでございますが、北朝鮮において、まあ、非常に幸せな生活を送っているというご印象でございますでしょうか。
そうですね、私はあの話したときに、まあ、恵みもそうですけれども、他の方たちも、それからあなた自身も どんなぐらいのところの生活をしているのかなっていうのを、いつもいつも思い巡らして心配してましたということをまずお話をしましたけれども、あって本当にまあ、北朝鮮には何もないものはありませんというようなことを主人になる人が言ってまして、それで雨とかもやっぱり日本の雨とかもカバンから出してきたりするような、まあ、本当にそういうふうにしてきたのかどうか分かりませんけど、何でもありますと、ないものありませんって言われて、あ、そうなんですかってびっくりして、まあとにかく、まあ、こんなに顔色も艶も良くて、本当に元気に明るくて、本当に屈託のない感じで生活をしているんだっていうことを目の当たりにして、本当に私たちは嬉しく思っていますっていうことを言いました。たくさんまだ日本に帰ってない人もね、いるので、そういう人たちもせめてあなた方ぐらいのレベルでね、まあ満ち足りたような生活ができていればね、本当に私たちはどんなに嬉しいかと思います。そういう話になるとちょっとこうデリケートな感じになるので、やっぱり言わない方がいいんだなと思って、それからちょっとこれはうまく話ができなくなるといけないなと思って、もうあとはもう普通のどこのおじいさんおばあさんと孫という感じの気楽な話を楽しくさせていただくようにいたしました。
So when we first met with Ungyong-san, we first said to her, you know, we worry every single day about how you have been living your life. We worry about Megumi. We worry about other abductees. What kind of life do you have? Do you have enough? We hear so many reports about things being lacking in North Korea that sometimes you don't...
日本のミルキーとか飴を、ね、カバンから出してきたんで、あ、日本の飴だって言って、政府の方が気づいて、
I mean, we heard that they didn't have a lot of basic foodstuffs, and so, for example, candies, we thought they didn't have, you know, different varieties. But when I took a little piece of candy from my Japanese candy from my bag, the interpreter immediately knew what that was, and our granddaughter also knew. And she said, you know, it's not like that at all for us. We have everything we need, and she seemed, as I said earlier, the color of her.Her health. She looked very, very healthy. Her color was good, and her skin was glowing. She seemed very, very happy and full of energy and full of life, and not holding back or hesitant or seeming to be weighed down or burdened by anything. So, of course, that felt filled us with great relief and made us very, very happy. And I did sort of begin to talk about the fact that, in regard to the other people who had not been able to return to Japan, we hope that they would at least be able to live the same kind of life as you were living in North Korea. But entering into that kind of territory, we thought might be politically sensitive and perhaps not such a good thing. And so we didn't want to create any trouble, so we pulled back. And after that, we didn't talk about anything in detail in that regard. We just had, again, this kind of normal conversation that you would see between any grandparent and grandchild and great-granddaughter.
Daniel, please.
Hello, I'm Daniel Eskenazi, freelance journalist of Switzerland. I was wondering if you could get any information regarding to your daughter thanks to those meetings.
はい、スイスのフリーのものでございます。今回の再開におきまして、まあ、めぐみさんについて何か新しい情報を入手することができましたでしょうか。
それは全くできませんでした。本当に一番私たちはそれを願って、どんな小さなことでも見逃さないで、感覚的に何かがつかめないかなっていう思いでおりましたけれども、やはり 孫と言ってもやっぱりこう向こうで育った人だっていう感覚ははっきりと意識ができるようになって、なかなか何から何までをこの日本の思いでバーッとこうぶつけて言うのも難しいなっていう感覚がやっぱりありましたので、それはできませんでしたし、そういうことはやっぱりなかなかはっきりと何も分かりませんね、全く分かりませんね、でも私は生きてると信じていますってもうはっきりと言って、帰る時も希望を持ってましょうねって言って、一生懸命向こうは何か分からなかったと思いますけども、一生懸命ちょっと涙ぐみながら にこやかに涙ぐんでこう手を握りしめて別れてきたんですが、絶対希望っていうのはもう捨てないでくださいよって、私も希望を持ってきてこうやって会えたんだから必ず希望を持って頑張りましょうっていうような言い方をして帰ってきたぐらいで、本当に拉致被害者のことは全く出せない感じでしたし、分からなかったですね。
Of course, that is the thing that we wanted so very much to be able to gain even the smallest glimmer of information, some kind of new information about our daughter. That is what we most wanted to have. But even though she is our blood, she is our granddaughter, even though she is our granddaughter, she is obviously a person that was raised in North Korea. And that is something that we very well and deeply understood after having met with her. So because she comes from a different background, a different way of thinking, for us to simply just throw our ideas to her, from a Japanese point of view or from a Japanese stance, that is something that we realized would be very, very difficult to do. In other words, she would probably not be able to respond in a way that we would want. Therefore, when we finally parted, at the very end, I couldn't help saying in a very loud voice that I still believe that Megumi's alive. I believe your mother's still alive. And please don't give up the hope that she might eventually be able to return. I said this very fast and very loud, and I don't know how much of that was translated or how much of that the granddaughter really understood. She just grasped our hands and held our hands very, very tightly and had tears sort of in her eyes. But the very last words I said to her was, please don't ever abandon hope. We want the returnees eventually to come back. But as I've said throughout, during these meetings, we really could not discuss the abductee issue, and we really not. It's just a big, big blank void for us. We have just no information, no understanding of what's happened, and that is something we could not learn anything about.
私はそういうことは一切聞きませんでした。やっぱり来るにあたっては政治的には利用しないとは言ってますけど、やはり積極的にではなくて消極的な方向で、こんなことについてはしゃべったらダメですよみたいなことを言われてると思ったので、まあ、それについては言えば何か答えなきゃならないと思いましたので、それについては一切質問はしませんでした。
From my side, I made a deliberate effort not to mention or ask any questions about this at all. Although the way that the meetings were set up was that there was this understanding that there would be no, this meeting would not be used for any kind of political gain. Still, I think that there are things that could have happened. I'm sure that she was probably warned in advance not to say certain things. And if we had tried to raise such topics, it might have in fact maybe hampered the meetings or maybe prevent future meetings. So I made a deliberate decision from the very beginning not to mention this at all.
Okay, back there, please.
TBS の庭と申します。いつも大変お世話になっております。ウンギョンさんの時は、ウンギョンさんが初めてこの世に出てきたときは DNA 鑑定というのをしたと思うんですけれども、今回お会いになったひ孫 の女の子の赤ちゃんというのは何かその DNA に関して調べたりとかそういった作業というのはされたんでしょうか。
それはありませんで、向こうそういう話を、まあ、DNA の話なんかも出てきて、この頃はなんか日本でもですけど小さい時の赤ちゃんの DNA っていうのはなんかあんまりはっきりとしてないことが多いので、どこでもあんまりしてないんですっていうようなことはちらっとおっしゃってました。
特に何
か運行さんにはやってますけどね、赤ちゃんのことですね。
So the question was about when your granddaughter first was revealed to the world, Eun-gyeon-san, I think there was a DNA test conducted to make sure that she was actually your granddaughter, and the results are positive. In regard to this new great-granddaughter, was there any DNA testing done to confirm that she was indeed your great-granddaughter? And the answer was that no such tests were done. In fact, it's been said even in Japan that although these DNA tests are very good, if you have a very, very young baby that is the test subject, quite often the tests are inconclusive. So no testing has been done.
Was your question answered, or did you want... Was your question answered?
ごめんなさい。途中で打ち切ったんでございますが、他にご質問があったんでしょうか。それでよろしかったんでしょうか。It's fine.
Please.
フリーランスの亀松と申します。先ほどめぐみさん の情報というのは特に得られなかったというお話だったんですが、お話をですね、ウンギョンさんとされている中で、ウンギョンさんの方からですね。まあ、彼女からしたらお母さんに当たるわけですけれども、お母さんの思い出話というような形で、めぐみ、まあ、お母さんこんな感じだったとか、めぐみさんこんな感じの思い出があるというような、そういう話はなかったんでしょうか。
それはこの歯の話が出てですね、それで私の歯は自分の歯ですかというようなことから聞かれて、自分のまだ自分の歯ですよということで、で自分もまだ今元気な歯なんだけど、お母さんは歯が弱かったということで、いつも歯医者さんに通ってましたっていうような話とか、赤ちゃんも小さい時にちゃんとね、歯を磨いてね、大事にしないと歯が悪くなるのは大変よねっていう話を、まあ、そのような感じで話したことと、猫がなんかやっぱり猫が好きだったんですね、昔からね、動物が。なんか猫がいたというような話とか、特別私に対して歌を歌ってくれたっていうことはなかったけどっていうような話とか、あんまり細かいことは話しませんけどね、まあ、その精子の問題は非常にこちらも出しにくいしタブーだし、向こうももうそういうふうにあの時にしっかり教えられたように、ね、思ってると思いますからね、非常に心をかき乱すことになるなって思ったので、もう全然それはもう聞かないで、絶対みんな元気だよっていうような言い方で気楽な感じで私を流して不思議そうな顔してこう聞いてるというか、そんな感じでした。
So the question was that you said that you were not able to receive any information about your daughter, but in regard to your granddaughter, Megumi-san was her mother. So were there some, during your conversations, were there some stories that were given by your granddaughter about her mother? And we didn't get into great detail. The answer is that we didn't go into great detail, but for example, Eun-gyeon-san asked me if my teeth were still my own or if I had false teeth, and I explained that these are still my own teeth. And so she said that her own mother, in other words, Megumi-san, really suffered from teeth problems, and she had to go to visit the dentist often. And so we went on with that conversation saying that you have to take very good care of your teeth, especially your baby's teeth, because good teeth are important throughout your life. She also talked about the fact that her mother loved cats, and that's something that we recognized in Megumi-san, in Megumi, our daughter. She'd always liked animals. And I think she, our granddaughter also mentioned that her mother didn't really sing songs to her that much. But we really didn't go into that many details. There were just little glimmers of information about Megumi as a mother. Of course, the thing that we most wanted to ask was and talk about was whether or not she was still alive, but we knew that we could not ask this question, and I think we felt very strongly that probably Eun-gyeon-san, having been raised in North Korea, completely believed what she had been told about her mother. And so, as I mentioned earlier, at the very end, I kind of make it a vague, ambiguous statement that we believe that everybody is still alive, not just saying Megumi-san, but everybody is still alive, and we hope everybody can come back. That's as far as we could go.
More questions over there. Carsten, you have another one, please.
Carsten Germes again. You told us that the video message was from when she was 15 years old, so some junior high school. girl, and now she is 28 or so, 26. So in between, you didn't have any contact, and when she sent the first message, she said she wanted to meet her grandparents in Japan. So there seemed to be some relationship to Japan. She had known she had grandparents there. So do you get the impression that there is some special relationship because grandparents are Japanese, that she, although raised in North Korea, has a, let's say, different way of looking at things, maybe?
先ほどの話でございますが、初めてそのウンギョンさんの存在を知ったときにはまだ15歳だった、そしてまたその今回お会いされましたときはもう26歳になってたということでございますが、その期間には全くその連絡とかコンタクトはなかったんでしょうかというのが最初の質問でございます。で、2つ目の質問でございますが、その最初にその15歳のときにおじいさんおばあちゃんに、おじいちゃんおばあちゃんに会いたいというメッセージが出たんですが、まあ、その段階で彼女はもう日本にいるおじいちゃんおばあちゃんということを言ってたので、やっぱりご本人としてはその日本人の血が流れてる、まあ、そういうような、そのつながりがあるというのは、まあ、分かってたというのが明らかなんでございます。ですので今回お会いされましたときにはやはりその北朝鮮の中で育った方なんでございますが、やはりその日本のバックグラウンドを持つということによって何かその日本とのつながりとか、なんかちょっと他の北朝鮮、日本と全く縁がないような方とちょっと違う雰囲気とか感覚があるというお感じはしましたでしょうか。
そうですね、ちょっと難しい質問、最初の質問は全くありませんということです。初めて会って、いろんなニュースどこから来るのか分かりませんが、ニュースでなんか政治なんだっけ、キム・イルソン政治軍事大学ですか、なんかコンピューター科に大学に入って勉強しているというような噂があったのを聞いてたりとか、で結婚したようだっていう噂を聞いてたりとか、どこからか入ってくるニュースで、そのぐらいのことは知っておりましたけど、後のことは分かりませんでした。でやっぱり全くまあ、日本人の血がつながっているから、そういう本当に日本の感覚とかそういうことはもうあんまり考えている余裕がない感じの、本当にある意味緊張したちゃんとした会見でないといけないという思いを持っていましたので、向こうに対してもやっぱり向こうが帰ってからまたいろんなことが起きないように言葉に気をつけないだろう、なければならないんだろうとかいうことも思ったりしながら、私たち自身もそれでも楽しく、せっかくの時間だから本当にもう水いらずで、いつもの私と本当そのまんまで笑ったり、向こうも大きな声を上げてうははって笑ったりとか、楽しく過ごしてくれたので、非常にその意味で良い対面だったと思いますが、そういう細やかなところはやっぱりなかなか分からなかったですね。まあ、あちらですでの暮らしをし続けてきた26歳だった女の子だということで見てあげなければいけないという思いで親しくさせていただいてきました。
Difficult questions. In regard to the first part of your question, we did not have any contact with her from when we first heard about her at 15 and until we met her at 26. This is the first time we've actually met her. Of course, over the intervening years, we had heard rumors and news reports that she had entered, for example, Kim Il-sung University and was studying computer science, perhaps, and that she had apparently gotten married. But there were only just rumors and information that we heard, no direct contact. And in regard to your question about the special relationship or perhaps something different about her that because of her Japanese background, we really were not able to discern whether she had any sort of special Japanese sensibilities or any special things thoughts about Japan. In fact, although we were meeting over a period of several days, we were both very, very in a sense, not nervous, but tense, because we wanted to make sure that the meetings go well. We wanted always to be able to ensure that the meetings went smoothly so that when she went back to North Korea, she would not encounter any difficulties. So we didn't talk in too much detail. We didn't go into too much depth about anything that might be particularly sensitive. But once we put aside all of those issues, we basically acted as a normal family, grandparents and grandchildren. I would just be my normal everyday self. Laugh out loud, and she would also laugh in a very, very loud voice, very full of energy. So in regard to details about her personality or backgrounds or her thoughts, etc., the what we came away with was the impression and the understanding that we value our relationship with this girl, we treasure her, and we would like to, we value her, but we have to understand that she is a 26-year-old woman who was raised in a separate country, in this country. Does that answer your question, sir? Thank you, sir.
Okay. Next one, please. Yes, back there in the corner.
朝日新聞北野です。いつもお世話になってます。ウンギョンさん の, まあ、旦那さんを含め普段の北朝鮮での生活がどんな暮らしだとかですね、旦那さんやご本人がどんな仕事をされているかとかですね、言葉の端々や仕草などからこういうふうに暮らしているのかなということがなんとなく伺えたとかですね、なんかそういうようなことがもし あればお伺いできればと思います。もう一つは、こちらにモンゴルにいらっしゃるにあたってウンギョンさんたちが北朝鮮の方ではどういうふうに言われて来ているかとか、どんないきさつで来たかとか、その辺について何か話していたかどうか。
So, I'm from the Yosai newspaper. Two questions. First of all, in regard to your granddaughter Eun Gyeong-san and her husband, looking at these people, were you able to get some kind of an impression about what kind of lives they were living in North Korea? For example, do you know if one or both are working and what kind of jobs they might be engaged in? And from little details about what they say, the way they say things and the gestures that they make, any impressions about what it might be like for them to be living in North Korea? And secondly, in regard to their having come to Mongolia, were there any indications about how about the process that got them to Mongolia, or how that visit was regarded in North Korea? Any kind of impressions about what led up to the meeting and their position, etc.?
あまり話さなかったんですけど、やはり夫は、まあ、近日制総合大学って言って、まあ、日本で言えば東大のような病院のコンピューター学科にいたということと、自分もその後輩だったということを言ってました。それと仕事の内容っていうのは言ってませんけど、なんか自宅から歩いて10分ぐらいのところで、自宅から歩いて10分ぐらいのところに、ね、勤めてるっていうようなことは言っておりました。ですからあまりそういうことを細々したことは話してなかったですね。
I neglected to say this earlier. First of all, in regard to Eun Gyeong as a husband, it was explained that he was also studying in the computer sciences department of Kim Il-sung University. Excuse me, Mr. Yogoda is saying computer department. The interpreter is assuming it's computer science. And that his wife was also in the same department, much younger. They also said that he worked in a place that was about 10 minutes away from their residence, but in regard to the kind of job he is engaged in, there was no specific details. They made no mention of their having received any special treatment because of who they were. There was just no mention of that at all.
Yes, please.
フリーランスで大倉と申します。割合長い期間いらっしゃったんですが、一日のうち何時間ぐらい一緒にずっといらっしゃったんですか。で、その間にちょっと外を建物の外を散歩するとかいうことはお出来になったんでしょうか。それから写真というのは全部北朝鮮側の公式のカメラマンが撮ったんでしょうか。それだけです。
So my freelancer, my name is Okura. I wanted to ask some quick questions. You were with your granddaughter for a period of days. How many hours each day were you able to meet with them? And were you able to sometimes go outside of the building and take walks together outside? And also in regard to photographs, were the only photographs that were taken taken by an official North Korean photographer?
そうですね、4階に あちらの方の家族は4階にお部屋がありました。3階に私たちのお部屋がありました。で、私たちも老人ですので非常に旅に疲れて、今回はもう特別疲れてまして、向こうは初めての飛行機だと思いますので、